Okay, so this is just a temp setup while I finish my coffee and decide whether I'm going to weld that joint or not. I put it together with a monkey wrench there, and she's gag-blank tight. And I don't foresee ever having to take it apart. If it goes together and it works well, then I don't need to take it apart. If it doesn't work, well, then I'll cut it off. But this is just a temp setup, and for now, because I need to get a jack under one end, and I couldn't do that with my full-size, with my 6-inch vise. And actually get something supporting the, square shafting there, rectangle shafting there. It's, 625 in one direction and 825 in the other direction. 875 in the other direction, excuse me. So, that's a half dow indicator. And by the way, that Craftsman vise is off by 22,000. So that's what's under there. Nice storet, 22 grand. And I'm thinking that she's vibrating on the half thousand indicator. And hopefully you guys can see that. But I'll just run back and forth real quick. Yeah. She vibrates on the Krudinsky. Hand cranking, and I'm thinking that a half thou on that is gonna be good enough. So we'll pull this out and decide if I'm gonna weld it or not while I finish my coffee. Yeah, cause that's all we really gotta do is a couple of ting-tings on there to keep that stuck together. I probably could do it with Loctite, but I don't know if I feel like taking it apart again. Yeah, we'll try it.
Is it? Well, I think it's going to be awesome enough for a drag cab. That Tractor Supply steel is, kind of gummy. And a little bit of chip welding going on. Yeah. And cutting through the welds was pretty rugged. But is it going to work for a drive shaft? I think so. Is it perfect? Absolutely not. Is it going to work? I think so. Yeah.
Well, how did it end up? Okay, it looks like this. There's my shaft. I don't know if we're all seeing that in here. Little tack welds and guess what? It's buried in a thing. So let's see if it fits. Oh, yes. Yeah, thanks for watching.